This is showing the robot following the user's head by tracking the head angle that is detected by the vision system and how the robot will respond accordingly and follow the user's face within an arcing motion.
The goal of this panel design was to mimic an aircraft control panel. It is also to simulate different button mechanics, selector switches, push buttons, latching push buttons, rocker switches with guards, and stuff like that. The main brain of this is an Arduino Nano. I needed 26 I/O points, so I obviously didn't have enough, so therefore I used I/O expanders, and those communicate over I2C. Here's a picture of them. I also used these manufacturer boards to step down 24 volt power to 5 volt power using 3 linear regulators. So there are different types of buttons and switches, potentiometers, selector switches, rocker switches. And we provide user feedback via LEDs and a 7-segment display. We also have an industrial touchscreen display, and this will just kind of mimic, you know, different things you might see on an aircraft control panel. And then moving down here, we have the control panel. This just kind of combines all the integrated hardware and everything we need into one neat panel. And then we additionally also added protective fuses for all the critical hardware to protect that.
So the HMI allows the user to view where the robot is within space in X, Y, Z, yaw, pitch, and roll. And then it allows them to adjust the height of the robot as they're using it and the radius at which the robot moves. And then also whether they're interacting with the KUKA or the FANUC robot. It'll let them know if there's any faults.
The PLC for the KUKA acts more of a pass-through between the vision system and the robot itself. And when the PLC is communicating with the robot, it uses the AnyBus converter to communicate between Ethernet IP and EtherCAT protocols. The PLC does a little bit more for the FANUC robot, but does act as a pass-through still between the vision system and the PLC. It has three different modes: sweep, random, and play. Sweep just has the robot sweep in between the max and min radius that is set on the HMI of the robot. Random, it generates random head angles for the robot to go to. And then play allows the user to interact with it and takes the feedback from the camera system and plots its course that way. And no, just cancels the program entirely. The robot receives the data from the PLC in the background, and then in the foreground program, the robot plots its path that it's going to take within a circular motion. The robot is collaborative, meaning it is safe to work with humans. If it bumps into you, it'll stop immediately and should cause no harm. Robot, we are still waiting on to be installed. I've been working with the Environmental Health and Safety Department at UC as far as working through the safety and installation procedures of this robot. At the time, the code for it is done, but we have not been able to physically test it until it has been installed.
The computer vision system is a Python-based library called OpenCV. The hardware includes a full HD webcam along with a desktop with a powerful CPU. This CPU is doing the processing and running the program. The code can be optimized for use on the GPU, allowing for much faster processing speeds, but that takes more time to accomplish and was outside of the scope of this project. The program is recognizing more than just the user's face. The nose, mouth, eyes and overall face are recognized and tracked. These facial features are used to mark 68 points on the user's face. The program then calculates the distance between each of these points and uses the results to estimate the head position. The head position is estimated and output in